Going downstairs. Going downstairs. Going downstairs. What's going on? Okay. Good afternoon and welcome to Monday with Michelle and OutLateButGreat. So that was Gabby. And she clearly doesn't care to be in the video. She's so funny. Usually when you go downstairs and one of them is up there and then you peek back up, they'll come and chase you, but I think the camera threw her off. She didn't know what to make of that. So this week we have open topic week on OutLateButGreat, and I hope you guys liked the last couple weeks of a little bit lighter topics. And this week is, since it's open topic, I don't know what you're gonna get, so you're just gonna have to stay tuned. But something happened over the last couple days, and I really wasn't even sure what I was gonna talk about today. But I thought, okay, this could be maybe something. It will not be very long. I got a friend request from somebody that I went to high school with now on Facebook. We've all had this happen, right? I have personally been, oh gosh, I hate to even admit this, but I have personally been out of high school for 33 years. Yeah, wow. Is that right? Yeah, I don't feel like it's been 33 years. Dang, that's a long time. Anyway, got a friend request from someone whose name I initially, when I saw the name, I'm like, who is that? And Kirsten says, go get your annual and look at your yearbook. And I thought, well, great idea. So I pulled out the yearbook, and as soon as I saw his picture of 33 years ago, I recognized who he was, and he was a nice guy in high school. Now, you know, a lot of time can go by, and you don't know how people turn out. You don't know what their leanings end up being or what kind of people they are, and you just don't know. So I did not hit accept right away. But instead, I went sleuthing around, fancy word for snooping, his page, because I wanted to see what type of person he was before I let him into my inner world. You know, I do the picture project where I take a photograph every day, and I generally don't post a lot of things other than that, unless it's something music related or something that I just feel is something cool that people might enjoy. I don't post about my day, or, you know, I just don't have a big online presence other than my photography project. And quite frankly, if it weren't for my photography project, I wouldn't mind taking a few weeks off of Facebook. I much prefer Instagram because it's all photographs. And for someone who's doing, you know, a photography project, this is like my cup of tea. And there's not a lot of drama, or, you know, just doesn't show up there, not at least not in the people that I have on my feed there. So after snooping around on his page, the first thing I saw that I thought, okay, this is definitely someone that I don't mind if they go, you know, once I accept their friend request, you know, people can just go snooping through every single photograph you ever uploaded if they so choose to do that, which would take a really long time. So I don't know who has that kind of time, but I know people do. I don't, but I know people do. And I thought, okay, I would be okay with this person looking through all my personal stuff, as personal as it gets on Facebook. And it was because he liked the page for Bernie Sanders. And no matter what your political leaning is, you know, Bernie is just someone who is a strong advocate for gay rights and LGBT rights. And so I figured if he likes Bernie, then he's probably not homophobic. He probably has a lot of the same core values that I do because I love Bernie. You know, I voted for Bernie in the primary. So I liked that, and after just a little bit more looking around, I saw something about suicide prevention, and I also saw something for our local, like, public radio and, you know, like the community radio that we have, and then I saw something about NPR, and I thought, okay, I definitely am going to let this person come into, you know, my page here. And I don't know how you feel about this, but I perhaps to some it might seem really silly, but I'm really kind of selective as to who I now bring into my online presence there, just because of everything that's showed up in the feeds over the last year. And I don't know, do you do this too? I'd really be curious to know how you handle these kind of situations when it's someone you don't really know. So while I'm trying not to be like, you know, exclusive and not let anybody in and be totally introverted, well, I don't know, I can't really be introverted to be on Facebook, right? But I think you understand what I mean. While I can't like change, you know, everything I see if I decide to go on there, because I do have family members that totally don't believe the way I do, I can certainly decide who is coming in newly, you know, new people that are coming in. Because we all have those family members who maybe have completely different political leanings than you, or I don't know, just other offensive things that you might see that they post that you really don't want to see in your feed. So for family members, there's this beautiful little thing that you can press called unfollow and then have not have them in your feed, but still remain on your list to be PC or, you know, not cause any waves in the family. So that's just a little something that I just thought about. And since I accepted the request 3 days ago or 2 days ago, we have been actually texting, messaging each other back and forth and catching up a little. I mean, how do you catch up 33 years? You know, I'm talking very generality type stuff, but he seems like he's a cool guy and we do have some things in common. So I'm glad that I hit the, you know, the request yes or confirm or whatever the button actually says. So I just wanted to talk about that briefly and ask if you do the same thing. And do you screen people before you let them into your online circle so that you could be maybe selective about who sees all your crap? I don't know. It's kind of silly in a way, but the least amount of negativity I can end up bringing into my life on a daily basis, I think the better. And so that's just the way I choose to live my life. And I haven't, you know, I've been posting my photography pictures, but honestly, I haven't been keeping up with a lot of everybody else's stuff just because life is getting busy now and school starts today here. And so my schedule is going to go kind of ballistic in the next couple weeks, which is fine. Okay, I hope you all have a great week and let me know how you handle these situations. Peace.